Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. And today I want to answer a performance-related question that someone asked me on my blog. Here it is. Some of my queries seem to be slow. Can Hibernate measure and log the execution time of a query? The answer is yes. It can do that and a lot more. Let me show you how. Hibernate's statistics component collects a lot of internal statistics and writes some of them to the log file. One of them is the execution time for each query. You can activate these messages in two steps. You first need to activate the statistics, and you need to configure the log level accordingly. Let's activate Hibernate's statistics component first. They are deactivated by default because collecting all this information slows down your application. So please, don't use it in production. The only thing you have to do is to set the property hibernate.generateStatistics to true. You can do that programmatically, with the system property, or in the persistence.xml file. I recommend using the system property because you can change it without changing your application. But in this video, I set it in the persistence.xml file because it's easier to show in a video. After you've activated the statistics component, you need to set the log level for org.hibernate.stat category to debug. I do that in the log4j.properties file. Let's perform a query and take a look at the log output. I prepared this simple JPQA query that reads the author entity with ID 1. As you can see here, Hibernate writes a log message that shows you the executed HQA statement, the execution time, and the retrieved number of rows. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!